What do you want me to say?
Street school, grandma.
Street school.
I'm trying to build like an army of people who are just straight positive, good people trying to help each other out. And I just think by doing that, that's how you build a community. So you got one person who will leave, learn something, come back, teach one more person. Now that person hit, now he teaching two other people.
Replicating yourself, bro. Exactly. Like, and now we was just talking about that, because I told Ray, like, you know, like, I told Trap, like, when we building a business, like, you know, sometimes, like, we might get so overwhelmed with work that you have to trust people to do a good job. You know what I'm saying? And so the best way to do that is to replicate yourself. Exactly. So if you're not the best you can be, you can't expect people to be the best. You know what I'm saying? They can be, especially when it's for you. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, that's dope, bro.
That's the biggest thing, is trying to build up everything. Because it's just too much violence, too much fighting, too much all of that, bro. And it's, that's what the world wants. It's world evil. So people like us who got that spark of the light, that's what we got to do. Keep trying to spread it. Yeah. It's Codi Miller-McIntyre. I just want to say welcome to Street School.
Free.
I used to feel so devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it. But now we on our way to greatness. And all that ever took was patience. I used to feel so devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it.
What's up, man? Codi Miller-McIntyre. Welcome to Street School, where you get the scoop on the streets, man. How you doing today, man?
Good, man. I'm good. Yourself?
I'm great, man. Thanks for asking, bro. I appreciate it. I appreciate you letting me, you know what I'm saying, be on the set while you doing your photo shoot with Trap Vision, man. That's dope, though. That's dope. We got some pretty good footage, and I know he got some great pictures, man. So, you know what I'm saying, you here, you home, like, what are you doing home? I thought you overseas professionally playing basketball, man.
Well, you know, our season just ended about 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
Back in town, relaxing, and then I got to get ready for the Mavericks minicamp in June 19th.
Okay.
I start up working out again Monday, so.
Okay, you're getting right back to work, huh? Exactly. That's what's up, man. That's what's up.
Time off.
That's what's up, man. You mentioned off camera that you are starting things outside of basketball as well. Do you mind elaborating?
Oh, for sure. So I started my own company called CMF Patience. Basically, it's the concept of patience. I think it's a long lost message, especially with our generation. We grew up with social media. We grew up with fast food. We grew up with delivery. So everything we want in life is fast. So the moment it takes us 2 years to accomplish something, we get this encouragement. So for me, I feel like I was sent here to kind of spread a message of what's meant to last is going to take long to get.
That's so dope.
That's kind of my entire message. I feel like with basketball, puts me on a pedestal to kind of spread this message.
Right.
Because I play ball, and when they meet me, I can introduce something so much deeper than basketball.
And speaking of basketball, you know, I wanted to get with you because you are actually a professional across seas, correct?
Right.
Do you mind mentioning the team that you play for or played for?
Yeah, I played for the Leuven Bears in Belgium.
Okay.
Nice little college town.
In Belgian waffles, man.
Exactly.
Oh, dope.
Fries.
Dope. The reason I bring it up is because, you know, we have a lot of kids that's you played for Wake Forest, right? You was a starting point guard there last year?
Yeah.
That's dope. So, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of kids. You know, Wake Forest is such a prestigious program. Like, it's a lot of people who want to be or have your type of success. You know, but, you know, you did go to overseas to play ball. And sometimes I don't think people understand how much opportunity it is outside of the NBA. Do you feel as though, like, you would do anything different or change anything? Or does the experience help you grow as a person?
Yeah, I wouldn't change anything at all. I think, for me, you can only truly grow if you ever spend time completely by yourself. So going overseas, being in a different country, away from family, friends, the people I love, it kind of puts you in a position of self-reflection. So the growth in the past year, I wouldn't have got that here in the States. I definitely wouldn't have did anything differently. I think I made the right choice. So I just continue to grow, and then eventually, maybe one day, I end up back here playing home.
That's what's up. Hey, well, listen, I'm gonna let you. I know you still got something to do with your photo shoot, so I'm gonna get back with you, man. We're gonna drop a couple, you know what I'm saying, scenes of what you out here doing, and then we're gonna finish this thing up later. Shit, man.
Wiggle to the Lord we pray, tryna be my best each day until I'm lit the rest of we late. Yeah, to the time being we lit, hoping I don't let it
get. The quotes that I've been repeating to myself, it's everything that I am, everything that I'm becoming. I'm only becoming that to give it back to the world.
Came up off the hustling, living in the lab of lux, and I'm feeling like the man. If you ain't no chucks, then you wouldn't understand. I'm me by these rubber bands.
I'm like yoga.
Yoga?
Yeah.
Oh, snap.
Bro, that's I did yoga once, but it really clear your mind. Like, you really got to be focused. And it will clear, you know what I'm saying, clear your mind. When you're doing the yoga, you won't even know you're doing it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You'll just be so relaxed, and you'll feel so much better. Like,
right. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying about that.
We were speaking on success and your career. Could you elaborate on that?
Yeah, I think one thing that's helped me out a lot is growing up, I've always had this vision of how I want to be. See that vision?
Uh-huh.
They kind of have so they don't really see it. Confidence. One thing I struggle with is being extremely confident in my vision and uh-huh. keep pushing towards it and keep making separation to the point where I would bring myself down to the level and to the mindset of the people that I was around. And one thing that's changed a lot is the fact that I know where I want to go in life and I know where I want to be. So instead of me coming down to the level of what people are and what people think I should be,
right.
I kind of keep raising the bar and to the point where one or two things will happen. Either the people I'm surrounded by are going to reach, kind of strive for the same things I'm striving for.
Right.
Or we're just going to separate. And I think that's the biggest thing, where separation is going to happen if you're trying to become successful, you're trying to do something positive in the world, and the people you're surrounded by aren't trying to.
So when you say successful, like, could you define it in your terminology? Because success does relate to everybody differently.
Yeah, for sure. I think with me, success is one, personal happiness. I think personal happiness is the biggest thing. Like, have $1 million if I'm not happy.
Right.
Successful. I think for me, personal happiness and knowing that I'm touching somebody else's life. So there's this allegory called Plato's Cave Allegory. And
uh-huh.
it is you have prisoners who are trapped in a cave. They've never been outside the cave. All they know is what's inside that cave. Basically, these prisoners are tied up and have been tied up in this cave their entire life. And behind the prisoners, you have a fire.
Uh-huh.
And in between the prisoners and the fire, you have objects walking by it. So the prisoners see the reflection of the objects walking by the fire on the wall of the cave.
Right.
So let's say a cat walks between the fire and the prisoners.
Right.
And on the wall, it shows an image of a bear. So the prisoners are like, this is a bear, blah, blah, blah.
Right. Not knowing
it's a cat.
Right. That's dope.
One day, a prisoner escapes the cave, and basically he realizes that everything that's on that wall isn't real. It's not the reality of the world. So this prisoner escaped the cave, this prisoner escaped the city, escaped his friends, escaped everything he's been taught growing up, and has developed a new perception of life. So now he sees that it's not a bear on the wall, it's actually a cat.
Right.
He sees that the money that's passing between the fire and the prisoners isn't happiness, it's actually just money. So
that's dope, bro.
That's what
Sorry, y'all, that's them Canapolis trains right there, you know, famous. Sorry about that, bro.
Yeah, so that's one thing I've been able to, I went through like a little depression state.
Mm-hmm.
I used to have extremely bad anxiety, and for me, I escaped it, and for me, I found the cure to escape it. So what I'm doing now is coming back to my city, coming back to
my
friends who are blinded by what they believe.
It's real and what's not.
Get out. I was able to study. I was able to meditate.
See life differently.
Exactly.
So. And all that ever took was patience.